गुड मॉर्निंग क्लास, आई मुकेश तिवारी वेलकम एवरीवन इन द स्मार्ट एग्जाम अकेडमी। वी आर हेयर टू डिस्कस द सेकेंड चैप्टर ऑफ योर हिस्ट्री बुक आई सी एस सी बोर्ड क्लास टेन। दिस इज द सेकेंड चैप्टर ऑफ योर हिस्ट्री बुक, द राइज ऑफ नेशनलिज्म, द फाउंडेशन ऑफ द इंडियन नेशनल कांग्रेस। In this chapter, we are going to discuss about the meaning of the nationalism, the definition of the nationalism, how can we define the nationalism, how the nationalism first emerged, how nationalism emerged in India. And another one, we will also discuss about the role and contribution of Jyotiba Phule and Ram Mohan Roy. And Jyotiba Phule. So these were the two important contributors who contributed to the origin of the idea of nationalism. Another one is the Indian National Congress. Indian National Congress I will discuss either in this video or the next video. So let's move ahead to start our discussion. So, the significance of the revolt of 1857. Why the revolt of 1857 was significant? You may tell that in the revolt of 1857 is also called First War of Independence. In this revolution, it was the first time that Indian rose against the exploitation of the British Empire. It was the first time when the people took up arms and they were exploited. The people came to know how they were exploited by the British Empire. So you can also tell it is important in this view, because another thing, the Hindu-Muslim unity. It was such a revolt in which both the Hindus and the Muslims fought unitedly against the British Empire. So, and they began to treat themselves as the Indian. So the idea of Indian, idea of being an Indian, is a sign of nationalism. So how can we define nationalism? If we forget our natural differences, if we forget our differences and identify ourselves as Indian, so it will be called the nationalism. Whenever we forget our idea, we forget our differences, and we treat ourselves as Indian first, it is called the idea of nationalism. In another way, we can tell that the idea of patriotism is related to the feeling of nationalism. To whom we are patriotic, to whom we owe our origin, that is called the nationalism. So the idea of nationalism first emerged with the revolt of 1857. That is the first chapter, the first war of independence of your ICSC book. So it was called the idea of nationalism, the communal feeling. The British people also came to know that if we can't rule country if the people are united in such a way, so we have to divide the country by creating a communal feeling. So you can write down the significance of the revolt of 1857 in a very short manner I have written. Let's move ahead. So meaning of the nationalism, this is the idea, this is the definition. So whatever I have discussed, whatever I have explained here is written in a very simple and one sentence. We can define the nationalism. Nationalism means love for his own country and the feeling of loyalty towards nation, forgetting their differences. What is the meaning of differences here? Differences means caste. India is divided into caste. India is divided into language. On the basis of language, also people of India are divided. Religion, we are divided. We have different religions. So whenever religions, place of birth, people are divided. Somebody is Bengali, somebody is Gujarati, somebody is Bihari. Place of birth also the people are divided. So if we forget all these natural differences and we identify ourselves as Indian, so this will be called the idea of nationalism. we have everybody's patriotic towards our own country. This is called the idea of nationalism, the meaning of nationalism. So I hope everybody has been able to understood the basic concept and the introduction. So let's move ahead to our next. Now we will discuss the factors promoting the growth of nationalism. How nationalism emerged. Certain causes were there behind the emergence of the nationalism. We can tell that the idea of nationalism is a modern concept which emerged after the arrival of the British into India. So how the British people began to exploit the Indian people. So economic exploitation, the people began to know about the economic exploitation of the British Empire, and they began to treat themselves as Indian, and they also understood that we have to be united. Hum logo ko ek hona padega. We have to be united against the British. Repressive colonial policies, the colonial policies were very repressive, and the British people were very cruel on the Indian people. They had no sympathy to the Indian people. It was also one of the important cause. Socio-religious reform movements. In socio-religious reform movements, we can tell the name of Raja Ram Mohan Roy and Jyotiba Phule. We will discuss later on about their contributions. Socio and religious reform movements, the abolition of sati practice was abolished, and the Indian people did not accepted this. So although the abolition of sati was a reform movement, but the Indian people had not accepted it. Indian people thought that the British Empire is destroying our culture. Widow remarriage act, it was also a reform movement, but the Indian people did not accepted this widow remarriage act. Now rediscovery of India's past. When the Indus Valley civilization, we came to know that India also had the culture. India had a rich culture in Indus Valley civilization. Another one, influence of the Western education, role of place, the modern means of transport and communication, etc. responsible for the growth of nationalism. These are the main developments which happened and which led to the nationalism. I hope you have been able to understood this economic exploitation, colonial policy, social-religious reform movements, rediscovery of India's past, Western education. Raja Ram Mohan Roy also said about the Western education press. So all these together contributed to the idea of nationalism in India. Let's move. Economic factors. We will discuss the economic, because it is there in your chapter in a very detailed manner. Economic factor in a very detailed chapter. If you see your ICSC book, Avichal publication, it is given in a very detailed manner. So we will discuss the economic exploitation for nationalism in a very detailed manner. Let's discuss. It was a economic colony. India remained a economic colony. What is the meaning of colony? Colony means we are under the colonial rule of the British Empire. The British people were indirectly ruling the country. They were exploiting the country. They were taking the raw material to their own country. After making it a finished product, they were again selling into India. So India was a colony, economic colony, and economic colony for the interest of the British Empire. Another, India was made to accept ready-made British goods. As I have said recently, that India was a source of raw material like cotton had a great demand into the European market, and Indian atmosphere is such that it produces large amount of the cotton jute and spices spices. These had great demand into the European market. So the British Empire were taking these goods and they were exporting it to England after making it into finished products. Once again, they were selling it into the European, into the Indian market. So it, India was made with the, India was, India had no option but to accept the ready-made British goods by the European capitalist class, by the European capitalist class at the nominal duty. The British capital invested in the Indian market, especially in the railway shipping. All these were made by the British Empire for their own interest, but indirectly railway shipping, all these contributed to the growth of nationalism. So you can write down all these points. It's very important for making the notes. I hope that everybody is sitting with pen and copy, so you can write down. It is very helpful for making of the notes. Let's move. Exploit of export of the raw material and the food grains. As I have said recently, that India was a British, India was a colony, and a source of the raw material, the British people were taking the raw material and they were carrying it to Europe, to England, where they were making it a finished products. After making of it a finished products, once again they were selling into India. So India was a colony. Colony, and India was also a market. India ek colony tha British ka, saath hi saath India ek market bhi tha jahan par British apne samano ko bech paaye. And the fifth one, salary and allowances to the English. Whatever the salaries the British people were getting into India, or the remittances, whatever the British people were getting into India, they were saving that salaries and allowances back to Great Britain. So Indian currency was going outside into Britain. Indian currency was going to UK. So India was gradually becoming poor. India was gradually becoming poor, and UK was becoming rich. Rich. If anybody is working in your country, he is taking the money and he is sending that money to another country. So India will become weaker day by day. India will become poorer day by day. Okay. So this is the meaning. Let's move. Yes. I will request everyone to subscribe the channel by pressing this, and please press the bell icon so that if any video, you will get the notification of that. Let's move ahead. The Vernacular Press Act. What is Vernacular Press Act? It is very important question. Many times in the ICSE board exam, this question appears. Every year, approximately every year, as a short question, as a long question, every year it emerged. It is a very important chapter. This is a very important concept, Vernacular Press Act. What was the question comes, what is Vernacular Press Act, who passed it, and what was the meaning of the Vernacular Press Act? So here we are going to discuss. The Vernacular Press Act means ban on the vernacular language, vernacular language on newspaper. Any newspaper would not be published into the vernacular language. Because why? Because in the British people began to think that if anything is published in the vernacular language, I would not be able to understand, and everybody would be able to understand, the common people would be able to understand, and if they criticize the British Empire, it will start the feeling of nationalism. So the British Empire put ban on the vernacular language newspapers, that they cannot publish anything in their own language. एक बार फिर से मैं बता रहा हूँ, द वर्नाकुलर प्रेस एक्ट ने किसी भी न्यूज़पेपर को अपने लैंग्वेज में लिखने से मना कर दिया. ये एक जुर्म होगा. इट वॉज पास्ड बाई लॉर्ड रिपन. इट वॉज द एक्ट दैट नो न्यूज़पेपर कैन बी पब्लिश इन द वर्नाक्यूलर लैंग्वेज सो दैट इंडियन पीपल वुड नॉट बी एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड द एक्सप्लॉयटेशन ऑफ द ब्रिटिश एम्पायर. यानी कि कोई भी न्यूज़पेपर हिंदी या किसी भी वर्नाकुलर लैंग्वेज में पब्लिश नहीं होगा, जिससे कि लोकल लोग ब्रिटिश के एक्सप्लॉयटेशन के बारे में जान पाएं. अगर वो जानेंगे तो नेशनलिज्म इससे लोगों में फैलेगा. सो नेशनलिज्म वॉज कर्ब्ड बाय द ब्रिटिश एम्पायर बाय पासिंग द वर्नाकुलर प्रेस एक्ट. हु पास्ड इट? लॉर्ड रिपन. लॉर्ड रिपन वॉज द गवर्नर जनरल एट द टाइम ऑफ पासिंग द वर्नाकुलर प्रेस एक्ट. सो आई होप दिस हैज बीन एबल टू आई हैव बीन एबल टू मेक यू अंडरस्टैंड. लेट्स मूव नाउ. कॉन्ट्रीब्यूशन ऑफ राजा राममोहन रॉय एंड ज्योतिबा फुले. इट्स अ वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट वन. राजा राममोहन रॉय एवरी ईयर वन और टू क्वेश्चन अपीयर्स एवरी ईयर. इन वन ईयर क्वेश्चन आर आस्क्ड फ्रॉम द राजा राममोहन रॉय, अनदर ईयर फ्रॉम ज्योतिबा फुले. टू क्वेश्चन एवरी ईयर कम. एवरी ईयर टू क्वेश्चन कम इन द ICSE बोर्ड एग्जाम एवरी ईयर, आइदर फ्रॉम दिस और फ्रॉम दिस. If we talk about the contribution of Raja Ram Mohan Roy, he was called the father of the modern education or the modern India. Why he is called the modern India? Because he was against the Hindu, the Indian old practices like the sati practice. He abolished the sati practice. That sati was made illegal because of Raja Ram Mohan Roy. Actually, Raja Ram Mohan Roy is called the modern thinker. So he is called the greatest social and religious reformer of the 19th century. Established Brahmo Samaj. It was an organization which was made by Raja Ram Mohan Roy. He was secular in character. He was secular because he was giving emphasis to all the religions. Another one. English education. He was the first Indian person who emphasized on the European language. That means English language. He was the first Indian people who asked for the English education into India. Liberty, equality, fraternity. He was inspired by liberty, equality and fraternity, the ideas of the French Revolution. So he is called the modern thinker. Why he is called modern thinker? Because he believed in the modern thinking, European language, the abolition of sati practice, secular ideology, liberty, equality, fraternity. He believed in these concepts. That is why he is called the modern thinker of India. Monotheism, that means believing in one god, every religion is same. This is the idea of monotheism. So you can write down these important points. It is very important one. Raja Ram Mohan Roy, the questions on Raja Ram Mohan Roy every year appears. Let's move. Raja Ram Mohan Roy believed in the unity of all religions. All the religions are equal. Unity of all the religion. Recently I have said about monotheism, that means worshipping one god and same unity of all the religions are equal. He attacked caste system is not important. The caste system, unity of all the caste, the polygamy. What is the meaning of polygamy? Polygamy means marrying more than one. That means keeping so many wives is the meaning of polygamy. So polygamy, he opposed against the polygamous practice into the Indian society. Child marriage. That means no boy or girl can be married before 18 years. after 18 years any girl can be married. Before 18 years of the age, no girl can be married. This is called the child marriage. He was against the child marriage. He was telling that the proper education should be given to the boy and the girl. Now, next one, practice of sati. I have said so many things. The practice of sati, he was against the practice of sati into India. So let's move to the next. Now, this is the picture. This is the picture of Raja Ram Mohan Roy. This picture is also given in your textbook, Avichal publication. This is also given in your book. Let's move ahead. Thank you. I hope that you have enjoyed the video and you have noted down all the important concepts whichever I have discussed in this lesson. It is very important. I have selected some of the important one which every year comes in your exam, and these are the accurate notes. If you write down these notes, you will definitely get the 100% marks. 100% marks, I assure you. I assure you that if you write these points, you will get 100% marks. So for the time being, this was the first video. I am coming with the next video also, second video also. Very soon I will be coming. Another one, I will request everyone to watch The Revolt of 1857, The First War of Independence. It is very important one. And another one, The Union Parliament. It is also uploaded. You will get the details in the playlist or in the description box. So for the time being, thank you. Have a nice day.